Today we're going to dive even deeper into the world of photography. We're going to be looking at some photographer confessions that you guys trusted me with. So thank you guys for that. At least someone trusts me. You guys trusted me more than my own family with these confessions. I mean, you guys wrote some deep stuff in there, some somewhat questionable things. I saw a couple of them that I'm like, should I tell someone? I know you guys gotta get it out, so here I'm doing it for you guys. So we got some new confessions. I'm just gonna go through some of the ones that I liked, so let's get started. I don't know what the F I'm doing sometimes. Girl, I don't think any of us do. Let's just say a prayer. Sometimes when I really don't want to work with a picky client, I just say that I'm booked. Then in that case, you're gonna be booked for a while, huh? These people are gonna start emailing you from like different accounts, different names. How are you gonna know?
You're playing a dangerous game, Kevin.
Sometimes I'm directing a model and don't know how to pose them, so I just play Twister in my head. I don't have a lot of good memories of Twister. The last time I was on one was when I was about 8 or 9 years old, and I ended up peeing on the Twister board, and that, yeah, ever since then I never got on a Twister board, so that's the story. I don't even know why I just said that. If a picture is out of focus but I like it, I'll sharpen it until it looks in focus. Completely blurry photo? No problem. Just bump up the clarity slider to like 500. Good to go. Send it off. Get a canvas print. Why even shoot autofocus? Just shoot manual, don't change anything, and just sharpen it after in Lightroom. Had a mean client, so I gave her pics back in low JPEG and she didn't find out. Hopefully she's not watching this video. My camera battery died on a shoot, so I told my client that I turned on silent shutter. You have to be the genius of the photography community. I mean, you deserve an Oscar for best performance at a photo shoot. Your IQ must be really high, because I don't know if I would be able to think of something like that. You're actually not taking pictures and they're like, oh, is everything going well? You're like, oh.
Silent shutter, they just, it's a new update yesterday. Oops.
You actually, the camera doesn't even, it looks like it's off. You gotta appreciate the creativity of people, you know? Things aren't going well, you gotta think of something. This person's a problem solver. I respect that. But also just don't forget to charge your battery, basically. In the future, you guys, don't go to a photo shoot with just one battery. Always have, you know, an extra battery and make sure they're charged the night before though, in all seriousness. This person asked me to shoot, but I was too nervous, so instead of replying, I blocked them. This one actually reminds me of me, but I wouldn't block somebody, I would be like, oh, I don't think I want to reply to this one. Goes for a 2-hour shoot and spends an hour and a half finding a location. And then I just end up taking pictures in front of a plain wall that I could have taken anywhere. I canceled the shoot saying it was an emergency. The emergency was I forgot my battery at home. If photographers had their own country, that would be one of our laws, I imagine. Forget your battery, forget your SD cards, state of emergency. So it's not that it's not an emergency, it's just not an emergency in the country that you're in. Because the one country, yeah. After this video, everybody, please go buy an extra battery. Please, just, I'm seeing so many messages about batteries. Called the model ugly on accident. But was it really an accident? Like how do you do that on accident? That would be very insightful if you told us how that you just had managed to just roast somebody in a regular conversation for a photo shoot. And now I just want to investigate this and figure out if it's really an accident or not. Calling somebody ugly. I don't know if it meets the requirements. Dropped my camera 90,000 clicks at the beach so my insurance can give me a new one. Okay, first of all, I just want to know the thought process behind this. One day you just woke up, you're like, okay, I'm just gonna like drop my camera into the ocean. Sally at State Farm is probably enjoying watching this video then, so I don't know. Sometimes I'll say I'm gonna get some lower angles, but it's just an excuse for me to sit down. Can you even blame her? Can you blame the girl? We're just saving our energy as photographers. We really want to focus on the photography. We got a chair, it has wheels on it. We're just gonna roll around from location to location. We're conserving our energy for the betterment of the team. And that's what I'll tell people when I'm being lazy. Just because you're a friend doesn't mean I'm gonna shoot for free. I barely know you, sis. Let's be honest here, sometimes people just want free pictures and you just kind of have to figure out who those people are. And it's really hard. It's really hard. It's like playing Mario 64, but on the hardest level. There's this scene in the movie Castaway where the main character has a volleyball and then the volleyball like floats away into the ocean. And he's really sad about it, but that's I don't know why. I just wanted to bring that up because that's depressing. I never got over that scene. Don't Google it, you guys. Just don't. Let those people be the volleyball. Let them float away. Live your life. And don't be used by people. I don't even take pictures of my own family. You think I'm gonna take pictures of someone that I don't even know, just friends with? Canceled on a couple after my ex posted a story getting ready for our shoot. Couldn't risk it. I forget to breathe when taking photos. You know, like when you forget to breathe, but you don't even know that you're not breathing, and then you just remember that you're not breathing. You're like, oh my god, I'm a psychopath. Like, I held my breath for that shot. Sometimes during a photo shoot, I would literally realize that I'm like holding my breath, and I'm like, girl, are you trying to kill yourself? Just let it out. Who has time to breathe when shooting a wedding? Let alone even go use the bathroom. Like, good luck taking a bathroom break, okay? I forget to breathe when taking photos. I forget to drink water. Hopefully you can last a whole day without. You can go for like 11 days, so you can be okay with that. Use the bathroom, have thoughts, function properly, cry. I mean, there's just so many things. Paying bills on time? Forget it, because the invoices are gonna be months late. So that's just a small list. Feel free to add down below, like comment some other things we can add to this list. One time my model did her own makeup for eyes, so I had her wear shades the whole shoot. I feel like models are actually really good at doing their own makeup, and whenever I have the models just come makeup done, it's usually pretty good. So the fact that you're telling me you had to put sunglasses on this girl, she must have looked like a straight up clown. Like, she was swinging on the ropes early in the morning at the circus, and then she came to the photo shoot with that same makeup. That's what I'm envisioning in my head to warrant wearing sunglasses the whole shoot. I'm curious to see the pictures from these photo shoots. Like, was it that bad? It probably wasn't. Most photographers get famous today because they shoot famous people, not because of their quality or skill. I mean, you're not wrong. But where's the lie? But is there not truth to that statement? There is. One of my client's photos turned out bad because she insisted on taking photos during a thunderstorm. So I told her that the rain ruined my SD card. I wasn't going to give bad photos. God bless you for taking pictures during a thunderstorm. I would have been like, it's not sunny out, so I'm not coming outside. What makes people think you're gonna get good pictures in a thunderstorm? I wanna ask her. I hate when people say, make me look skinny. Like, okay, I'll turn your ass into Slender Man. I get that comment a lot as a photographer, especially like, oh, can you like change my body? Can you change my face? Like, fix this? And it's super awkward, especially when you're talking about other people's appearances. You don't want to like offend somebody. At the same time, you also just don't want to go down that road of like just morphing people's bodies. So it's kind of like, no matter what, it's you just laugh. Just laugh. There's nothing you can say. Every photographer watching this has been told this, one photo shoot or another, 100%. It's super awkward to get a comment like that because, like, what are you supposed to say? When someone tells you, oh, can you make me skinny? Can you change my face shape? Can you just, like, take off 10 pounds? Like, what are you gonna say? No, you're staying the way you are? Like, when a client is ugly, I decrease the exposure. I shot my first wedding yesterday. Never again. Weddings are not for everybody. I think people really underestimate how chaotic and crazy weddings are, especially for the photographer. So if you're not the one getting married, weddings are pure chaos. Oh, were you expecting more confessions? Because actually, that's it for today. Those are all the confessions that I have. But fear not, because I have a feeling that people out there are experiencing some things that they're going to confess to real soon. Maybe I'll do another one of these. Let me know down below in the comments, what was your favorite confession? What did you think? As always, I would love to thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you guys later. Bye.